First tonight, the imposition of Sharia law by the so-called Islamic State in the Middle East has caused many in the West to recoil. But you may not be aware that similar Islamic laws are now in force much closer to home in the Indonesian province of Aceh. Strict new laws there are subjecting both Muslims and non-Muslims to harsh punishments for drinking alcohol, gambling, homosexuality and extramarital sex. Patrick Aboud travelled to Aceh, where he gained unprecedented access to the province's notorious morality squad.
She broke Islamic dress code. He was caught gambling. This is life under Sharia law.
Wanita yang memakai baju ketat itu dapat mengundang hal-hal yang kurang bagus gitu, umpamanya seperti pemerkosaan. Sebenarnya kejahatan itu kan datangnya karena kita yang mengundang sebenarnya kan.
Sampai kita ketakutan, mau keluar takut, harus apa.
Cambuk tadi yang 9 kali tadi itu adalah sangat ringan.
We're dealing with a very dangerous man. All we can do is get away as quick as we can.
I'm in the city of Langsa in the Indonesian province of Aceh. The Sharia police control the streets here.
Kalau hukum Islam yang sesungguhnya, laki-laki yang sudah beristri, perempuan yang sudah bersuami, dia harus ditanam di tengah jalan.
Captain Ibrahim Latif is in charge.
Ditanam yang laki-laki ditanam sampai sini, siapa di persimpangan jalan, siapa yang lewat harus melemparnya sampai ia mati. Yang perempuan, karena dia sudah punya suami, dia harus ditanam sampai di sini dan dilempar sampai mati.
The law he and his Sharia police team are enforcing is not justice as most of us would know it. Their work is all in the name of Allah.
Selaku seorang Muslim, saya bertanggung jawab juga kepada Allah. Jadi untuk menegakkan amar ma'ruf nahi mungkar.
Bisa depan!
This is the first time Captain Latif has allowed cameras to follow him and his Sharia police team so closely. Today, we're at one of their routine street raids. A checkpoint is set up, and within minutes, dozens of women are being pulled over. The female Sharia officers interrogate the women about their clothing. These girls were on their way to school. Their bodies are covered head to toe, but their pants are too tight and their hijabs too revealing.
Ada yang dia lihat, kalau nafsu itu nggak datang macam mana pelaku itu mau. Sekarang kan tergantung kitanya yang mengundang si perempuan ini, kan kayak gitu. Banyak dari lekuk-lekuk tubuhnya yang bisa membuat birahi laki-laki itu.
Captain Latif, those girls told me they're just 15. Are they not too young to be punished?
Bisa 15 tahun, bisa 9 tahun. Jadi kalau dia sudah datang hit, sudah wajib hukum syara kepadanya. Yang laki-laki, apabila dia telah mengalami mimpi-mimpi basah.
In addition to strict Islamic dress codes and harsh punishments for adultery, living with Sharia law in Aceh, Muslim or not, demands no alcohol, no gambling, no homosexuality. Sharia law here also prevents single men and women from showing public affection. If you dare disobey Sharia law in Aceh, the penalties are severe. Caning is common. In extreme cases, up to 100 lashes. Some crimes come with a prison term of more than 3 years. Others escape physical harm and instead pay a fine of up to 800 grams of gold. And punishments are set to get even worse under Captain Latif's deadly rule.
itu terbukti orang mencuri, itu bisa dipotong tangan. Terbukti yang membunuh, kita bila siap melakukan hukum kisas.
Aceh is the only part of Indonesia allowed to enforce Islamic Sharia law. It's been implemented here since 2001, when Aceh gained some powers of autonomy. The province struck a deal with the federal government in a bid to reduce tension with rebels. Captain Latif takes us to his police headquarters. He's arranging tonight's raid on unmarried couples. Under the laws of seclusion, they'll hunt down single men and women who are together in what he calls dark places.
Tapi kalau dia sudah melakukan hubungan badan, hubungan suami istri, kita ajak pihak keluarga untuk menikahkan mereka secara resmi. Ketika mereka tidak mau menikahkan secara resmi, maka kita ajukan dia harus dilaksanakan hukum cambuk terhadapnya.
While we wait for tonight's raid, we head across town to meet a brave woman speaking out against Sharia in Aceh for the first time.
Masih ini juga, masih was-was juga kan. Mungkin ini saatnya juga kan untuk mengungkap ini.
Although a devout Muslim, like many in Aceh, she says the issue here is the heavy-handed enforcement by Captain Latif and his Sharia police.
Cuma di sini kita kan nggak mendapat kesempatan bicara, nggak dapat kesempatan untuk nggak sebebas-bebas terus kita suka gitu. Ya marahnya dalam hati aja lah. Mau gimana kan orang itu peraturan dia dibuat gitu.
Her only form of resistance is a network of women that conspire to avoid the Sharia police traps.
Ya daripada dirazia, kita takut nanti kena razia. Nanti diinformasi sama kawan, jangan lewat sana tuh ada razia. Jadi belum pernah ketangkap, saya minta-minta jangan lah.
But others are not as lucky. This 16-year-old schoolgirl was arrested by Sharia police in 2012, accused of immorality. There was no proof, but Captain Latif had the arrest publicised. Devastated, she hung herself, leaving this suicide note.
Father, forgive me. I have brought shame on you in the eyes of everyone, but I can honestly say that I have never sold my body to anyone. I will be sad not to see you again.
Her parents are still too afraid to speak out. Her uncle says the family will never recover.
Majalah gitu, dibuat kita kandronti ABG gitu, karena ada menjelekkan nama dia, nama keluarganya.
In May this year, a 25-year-old woman was discovered in this house with a married man. Eight vigilantes, including a 13-year-old boy, gang raped her.
Maksud saya bukan mengajak, tetapi mengundang. Mengundang laki-laki tadi karena si perempuan ini berpakaian super seksi. Saya rasa laki-laki normal itu akan terpancing itu.
Three of her rapists have since been arrested and are in custody to be tried by the National Criminal Court System. However, the rape victim has gone into hiding, fearing retribution. If found guilty of adultery under Captain Latif's version of Sharia law, she will be caned.
Cambukannya tidak sakit, tetapi yang membuat dia adalah malu di depan umum. Itu harapan kita supaya menjadi jera dan menjadi pelajaran kepada yang lain.
And in an unexpected turn of events, we were now in danger.
I thought the planets were going to go to.
My questioning had aroused Captain Latif's suspicion that we were in town to shame Islam.
We've basically just got a phone call from the head of the Independent Federation of Journalists in Bandar Aceh, who's advised us to leave town immediately.
Well, he told me that his contacts are saying that there's bad rumours about what you're doing here, and he suggested definitely don't go on the raid tonight, which we were planning, and to get out of town.
tidak ada arti juga kita melakukan peliputan ketika kita dalam kondisi tidak nyaman.
Warned that it was too dangerous to stay, we had no choice but to leave Aceh. The next morning, the local paper headline read, Australian journalist monitoring Sharia law. With my photo on the front page, we were a sure target for Captain Latif's devoted followers. Human Rights Watch is urging the Indonesian government to revoke the implementation of Sharia in Aceh.
People like Ibrahim should be investigated. There are many, many men like him all over Indonesia, not only in Langsa. They are abusing their power.
Walaupun dia punya otonomi khusus ya untuk bidang syariah lah, nah, tapi tetap itu tidak boleh bertentangan dengan undang-undang yang lebih tinggi. Nah, jadi ini penerapan hukum syariah yang keliru.
The Indonesian government, the Jokowi administration, should stop it, should reverse it. If it is not to be reversed, it is going to bring Indonesia into a great problems. The reason is simple. A modern society cannot move forward if they leave half of the society members, women in this case, behind.
Almost a decade after the devastating tsunami and the end of 26 years of rebel conflict, Aceh would seem entitled to enjoy some peace and stability. But with Islamic fundamentalism on the rise and Captain Ibrahim Latif ruling with an iron fist, it seems the future for the people of Aceh remains shrouded in fear.
Patrick Abood filming and reporting there. And Patrick is on Twitter now to answer your questions about his time on patrol with Aceh's morality police. And if you'd like to know more about Sharia law and its background, there's an explainer article on our website.